Fine. So today we are going to understand sets and subset. Like subset, what is called as a subset, and important questions related to subset today we are going to study. So first understand concept of subset. What is exactly called as subset? Fine. Many children are having confusion related to subset. Always they misunderstand subset with another set. Fine. So definitely subset is a set, but it is exactly smaller than a set. Subset is smaller than a set. I repeat. Okay, subset is smaller than a set. Fine. So subset is smaller than a set. Now look here, I'll be teaching you subset. Now if A is a set containing from the main set. Okay, correct only, Saranya. So we will be seeing beta subset and how supersets are there and proper set. So today I'm going to teach the concept of set, subset and proper set. Fine. Set, subset and proper set. To open the chat box. Okay, huh. I got the answer. Subset is formed from the main set. Correct. Now look here, beta. If B you are writing and B is a set containing element 4 and 5. C is a set containing element 1 and 2. D is a set containing element 3. Now among them, which one is exactly subset of A? Definitely B is a subset of A. Because all the elements of B is in A. So that's why B is a subset of A. B is a subset of A. Now next is about C. Now tell me about beta C. Is C subset of A? Okay, Anila is telling auntie B, C, D all subset of A. Saranya is also saying. So look here, beta. C is a subset of A also. And D is also a subset of A. B is a subset of A. C is a subset of A. And D is a subset of A. All are subset of A because look here. Now, understand this. Here, C is exactly, D is exactly containing one element 3. And it is present in set A. Next. 1 and 2 is present in C, it is also present in A. That's why C is a subset of A. Next is, you see here, B is exactly having 4, 5 and 4, 5 is present in A. So definitely B is a subset of A. Now, can you tell me, is C a subset of B? Very good, Pavitra, Anila, everyone is telling yes. Okay, Anila is telling no. Saranya is telling no. Saranya, Anila, Bhumika, they are saying no. Correct only, beta, because the element of C is not present in B. The element of C is not present in B because of that C is not a subset of B. Because of that C is not a subset of B. Because of that C is not a subset of B. Okay, C is not a subset of B. Because of that, C is not a subset of B. Hence, it is exactly not possible. Okay, so now let's go for next one. Now, what is called as a proper set? Okay, now I'll just write the definition because some of you will be wanting definition of it. So, definition I'm writing. Hello? Hello? Okay. Now, look here. What is the definition of subset? So let A and B be two sets. Okay, if every element of A is an element of B. Then A is called a subset of B. Okay, that means if every element of A is present in B, like A is containing 1, 2, and B is containing 1, 2, 3, 4. So definitely A will be called as subset of B because A's element is present inside B. A's element is present inside B, then it is exactly called as subset of B. I hope you might have understood this one. Dhanashree understood, beta. Correct, Dhanashree gave answer also, super beta. So previous one, Dhanashree has given the correct answer, Bhumika has given the answer, Anila, everyone gave the answer. Kritika is present today? No. Fine. So all these children, Kritika and Kriti Maya, both are not present, I guess. So they have given, Arvind understood the concept, beta. So this is very important concept, Arvind. We have to understand this concept because based on this, many big, big questions you are going to solve. So today itself, understand that if all the element of A is present inside B, then B is more powerful. So B can contain A. So look here, in Venn diagram, you can say this is B and this is A. Now, B is exactly containing A inside. Why? Because B and A both are having two elements in common. Both are having how many elements in common? Two elements in common. And rest of their element is 3 and 4. Fine. Rest of their elements are what? 3 and 4. So this is exactly called as Venn diagram. It is denoted by U as like that. So this is exactly case of subset. Now how to represent subset case in variable format? So if A is a subset of B, if A is a subset of B, okay, that means we can write A is a subset of B. A is a subset of B. That means then, symbolically, if any element present in A, if any element is present in A, then it will 100% be present in B. Okay, if A is a subset in B, I told you now that if, see, look here, understand. Here, 1, 2 is there and B is exactly having 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever number you want. So definitely, here A is a subset of B. Now, since A is a subset of B, whatever element of A, so here 1 belongs to A, then here 1 is also belonging to B. Because 1 is an element of A, then definitely 1 is also an element of B. Here 2 belongs to A, means 2 is an element of A, that means 2 is also belonging to B, that means 2 is also an element of B. 2 is what, beta? 2 is also an element of B. 2 is an element of A, also 2 is an element of B. Understood, beta? Understood this one? What is a case of subset? How to represent, beta? So always whatever element of A will be there, it will 100% be element of B. Whatever will be the element of A, it will become the element of B if A is a subset of B. If A is a subset of B. If A is a subset of B. Okay? Arvind understood, beta? Anila, Dhaneshwari understood, beta? Correct. Thank you so much, everyone. Dhanashri told, she understood. Beta, this is exactly called a symbol. This stands for implies. This symbol is exactly standing for implies. Implies. Implies means it is applicable. Okay. And this is exactly implies and implied by. Implies and implied by. Because many a times I'm using the word then, So you have to understand, this is exactly called as implies. What it is called as? Implies. And when two arrows will be there, that means implies and implied by. And implies and implied by means what? Here it is exactly one way channel. Means if first one is true, then second one will become, the second one is also there. But if implies and implied by is there, means there is a two way channel, 1 to 2, 2 to 1. Means A1 is equal to A2. That means if A1 is equal to A2, then A2 is equal to A1. A1 is equal to A2, then A2 is equal to A1. Implies and implied by means this one. I hope you might have understood. Okay. Okay. Daneshwari told she understood. Thank you, Bita. Now some very critical point I am going to touch. Pavitra said she understood. Very good, Bita. Now we are going to understand what is the meaning of proper set. Okay, now superiority. About superiority also, sometimes they are saying superior words. Superior words means what? Then you will be asking, auntie, here what is superiority you want to say? Superiority, like here, if someone will say that A is containing 1, 2, 3 elements, and B is exactly containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements, then definitely A is a subset of B. Okay, then definitely A is a subset of B. Then beta, that means what? Who is the boss here? Who is the boss here? Very good. Anila, Pravit, Pavitra. Who is the boss? B is the boss here. Bhumika, who is the boss here? B is the boss here. Okay. So that means what, beta? B contains A. So here, since B is containing maximum element, so what you are going to say, you can also say that A is a subset of B. Or B contains A. B contains A, or B is a superset of A. So you can express it in different ways. Means A is a subset of, arre papa, A is a subset of B. B contains A, means whatever element of B is there, B is exactly containing A. Means whatever element A is having, it is present inside B. That's why B contains A. And B is a superset of A. B is a superset of A. Why? Because B is having extra element and A is having less element. And A is all element is present inside B. A is all element is present inside B. Because of this one, it is also called as B is a superset of A. B contains A, B is a superset of A. B is a superset of A. What is B, beta? B is a superset. Again and again, I am saying B is a superset of A. Okay. Now one concept of, till here understood or not? Tell me first. Till here understood or not, beta? Tell me. Anila said understood. About others understood this part, beta. So you can call it, Dhaneshri understood, Bhumika understood. Thank you, beta. So look here, Saranya understood, beta, Arvind. So here one very simple thing here, Pavitra understood, beta. So here one simple thing is that you can call A is a subset of B in three names. B contains A, B is a superset of A is a subset of B. Now one next condition is proper set. Now let's talk about proper set. That is exactly called as proper subset. Proper subset. So exactly what is proper subset? Now I'm writing about proper subset. A subset A of a set B is called proper subset A subset A of a set B is called proper subset. Is called what? Proper subset. Is called proper subset if if A is not equal to B and we can write it as like this. So, beta, you have to understand one simple thing here is that when number of element, see, when two sets will be equal, can anybody tell me what is the condition of two sets to be equal? Anyone please say what is the condition of two sets to be equal, beta? Condition of two sets to be equal. What is the condition when two sets will be exactly called as equal? When their last class itself, I told you now, when two sets will be equal, when their cardinal number will be same. Means number of element in set A is equal to number of cardinal number and elements are same. Cardinal number is same and elements are same. Then only it will be called as equal sets. Okay. Now here they are telling that usually now all the sets are proper sets. All the sets are proper sets. The reason behind is here, whatever example I have taken very cleverly, I have used only proper set. I have never used subset. But you know what? It is a representation, means proper set, rather than writing proper set for unknown variables, we use subset. Because we which content we are not sure about, there we are using subset, there we are not using proper set. Like where we are very much confident about, na, just say, look here, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So definitely here, you can see A is a subset of B. Because whatever element is present in B, that is exactly present in A. But here A is a subset of B. But A will be called as proper set. Why? Because number of element in A is not equal to number of element in B. Number of element in A is not equal to number of element in B. So here A is a proper set of B. What is A? A is a proper set of B. Okay. So, beta, because here A is having three elements, you see here nicely. A is exactly having how many elements? Three elements. B is having five elements. So, definitely, whatever element in A is there, it is present in B. So, it is exactly called as proper set. But, beta, this is when you are going to apply when. Exactly, when number of A element is not equal to number of B element. So definitely number of A element is not equal to number of B element. How many elements are present in A? 3. How many elements are present in B? 5. But then too, we are not writing subset. The reason behind is, here we are writing proper because we know 3 elements. Here also 3 elements. We can see. But what if I am writing A belongs to A and B belongs to B? So in this case, specifically, if I am writing the word content at that time, specifically, we have no other option. So we will write A is a subset of B. Means again, I am explaining when number of element present in a set. Here, number of element present in a set is nicely represented because I have represented A as 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But one condition will be coming where you cannot represent the number of element. So at that case, what you can do here is there by default already it is coming A is a set of B. That means you can use A as a proper set of B where it is not notifying number of elements, but where number of elements are exactly not notified, here only rough sketch will be there, then proper way is to use this A is a subset of B. So where not, you don't know how many element is having A, how many element is present in B, that time you are using A is a subset of B. But when you have all clear idea, then it will only be a proper set. I hope you might have understood. So let's see one difference, then I think you will be able to understand. Now tell me what type of example it is, where you can use proper set and where you can use subset. This is case one. And if you will not understand, I will explain one more time. So get ready if you have not understood to say no. That ma'am, explain one more time. Auntie, explain one more time because I have not understood. Okay, Sarane, I'll explain. Case number one is proper and case number two is subset. Okay. Anyone else wants to answer? Anila gave an answer. Case one is proper subset. Daneshwari, well done, beta. Bhumika, case one is proper subset. Now I'll explain. Arvind, understand, beta. Arvind also, I think he's having weak connection today. Now look here, beta. Here, one very important thing is that is when it is very much clear to you that A is 1, 2, 3, B is 1, 2, 3, 4. So definitely whatever element of A is there, it is present in B. So directly we will say that A is a proper set because A element is present inside B, but A is not equal to B. Here, element of A is not equal to element of B, na, because B is having an extra element. So A is a proper set, but A is not equal to B. Okay, A is a proper set, but A is not equal to B. Here, exactly X plus 1. X plus 1 can be A set of natural number. So it will start with X plus 1. So if you will keep on putting the value, it will start with 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it will keep on going. So this is B. So definitely here, whatever element of A is there, but we are not sure, beta, ki always it will come. So B will be a subset. So when this type of representation is there, which is not clearing the fact and you have to take it out, it will always be a subset. But in the question itself, if 1, 2, 3 is there, so taking out the content is easy for you. Analyzing the content is easy for you. That's why that will become a proper set. Proper set means you are knowing that element in A is exactly present in B. Which element is A in present in B? That is what it is called as ki for any set A, for any set A, set B is called a proper set of a subset of A is exactly called as proper subset if A is not equal to B. Here in both the cases, A is not equal to B. Okay. And A is a proper set of B because here numbers we cannot. But here, beta, A is not equal to B, we cannot say because it is going infinity. Because it is going infinity and infinity, will they be bigger or smaller? We don't know. So that's why we will write definitely A is a subset of B. What you are going to write? A is a subset of B. I hope my children understood how to do this question. Okay, proper set and subset, there is one difference, beta. Proper set is telling ki if A is equal to 1, 2, Saranya, then B will also be exactly 1, 2. A is exactly having 1, 2. B is also exactly having 1, 2. Then definitely A is a subset of B. Okay, then it is a case where, beta, you can see the number. So here you can say A is a subset of B or B is also a subset of A. And this is equation one and this is equation two. Hence, by final content, we can say A is equal to B. Then we can say what A is equal to B. What we can say at that time, A is equal to B. Okay, next part is Saranya, given A is equal to 1, 2 and B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So definitely, beta, exactly you are knowing A is having two element and B is having two. So A will become proper set of B. But when a set builder form is there where you are not knowing what presentation is needed, because here it is given in general. okay, till finite it can go. So that's why it will become subset. Okay, so where you cannot be able to find the particular numbers, there you are going to use subset. There you are going to use subset concept by default. So whatever proof we are going to do, by default, their concept of subset will be there. There what will be there? Concept of subset, not proper subset. In very rare questions where they will reveal the element, that time you can add. Okay, Saranya, I hope you might have understood beta. Let's go for next one. So all the three over na beta. Now you have to identify. Quickly say. Screen, sometimes it is getting jammed. Super. Write the correct notification for here, beta. What notification you are going to write about it? Write about subset condition. Correct, A is a proper subset of B because we are getting the element name. So A is a proper subset of B. You can also say A is a subset of B because we don't know. And B is a subset of C, correct? Also A is a subset of C. Okay, just 1 minute. Hello, beta. We will join the group again. Hello, can you hear me? So this one you have understood or not? Tell me. This one you have understood or not? This section you have understood or not? What to do here? So A will be exactly here. A is a. Okay, let's see how many of you have given the answer. Fine. Okay, why? Understood. Okay, so here beta A is a subset of B, B is a subset of C. And we can also say A is a subset of or A is a proper set of C. Because C is containing one also inside it. So C is a proper set of B. So we can follow the sequence like that also. A is a subset of B, B is a subset of C. Or A is a proper set of B, B is a proper set of C. B is a proper set of C. So like this presentation we can do. Like this presentation we can do when A is a subset of B and B is a subset of C. I hope. Correct only beta. C is a superset of A and B. Correct Anila. C is also called as superset of A and B. C is also called as superset of A and B. Okay, C is also called a superset of A and B. Now, beta, one very important information in theorem section. So just note down the theorem section. In theorem section, one very important point, you need not to prove it, but you have to understand that phi is a subset of every set. means if any empty set is there, then this empty set will be subset of every set. So empty set can be subset of every set. This one you must remember, phi is a subset of every set. Phi is a subset of every set. Phi is a subset of every set. Phi is what? Subset of every set. Phi is a subset of every set. Fine. Now next one, beta. Power set. Next important concept is power set. But beta, you have to remember one very important thing. Phi is a subset of every set. Means empty set is a subset of every set. I repeat, empty set is a subset of every set. Empty set is a subset of every set. Okay? Empty set is a subset of every set. Now look here, beta. If someone will talk about power set of A, what is power set of A? Exactly, power set in simple, you will understand that power set is a subset. It is a combination of all the subsets present inside a set. Means if exactly A is a set containing three elements. 1, 2, 3. Then what is the power set of A? Then power set of A means what are the possible subsets of A? What are the possible subsets of A? What is power set of A? Possible subsets of A. What is exactly power set of A? Possible subsets of A. So possible subsets of A can be phi also. Means it is possible, it may be possible that A cannot have any element. Then A can have a subset having only one. A can have a subset having only two. A can have a subset only three. And then A can have a subset containing one and two. Then A can have a subset containing 2 and 3. Then A can have a subset containing 1 and 3. Okay. That means 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3. Ulta you cannot go. Opposite you cannot go. And 1, 2, 3. So these are the possible subsets a subset is exactly having. A set is exactly having. So how many it is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that means A is equal to 1, 2, 3 elements are there. It is having 2 to the power 8 elements. Two to the power three elements, that will be exactly equal to 2.